the media and the Medea complex. Those who listen closely to these commentaries know that I've not said word one about the Casey Anthony case. The reason? Simple. I've never believed it was a national story. It was rather a bubble blown up by cable networks, a kind of real reality show featuring beauty, tragedy, and implied sex. If Casey were Mercedes or Keisha, in other words, Latina or black, we wouldn't know her name. But a pretty white girl and a beautiful blue-eyed baby equals ratings gold. And cable TV program directors latched on like crocodiles on chicken. It was exploitation in the very beginning, and it's exploitation now. A modern-day Medea story to shock, but also to entertain American audiences, to divert us from the increasing crumminess of life in a declining empire. When the Greek playwright Euripides wrote Medea 2,400 years ago, he shocked the stage with his portrayal of angry, vengeful women. Medea, not to be confused with Tyler Perry's comic creation Medea, was a sorceress who loved and married the Greek explorer Jason of the Argonauts fame, who soon fell in love with another woman. Medea sent his new love a wedding dress that killed her, and then killed her own and Jason's two children. So mothers who slay their kids, while terrifying and abhorrent, reside deeply in the Western psyche. And speaking of psyche, psychology and history writer Barry Spector, author of Madness at the Gates of the City, writes that it isn't just in our minds. According to Spector, America is exceptional, for it has the highest rate in the world of parents who kill their own young children. As the economy crumbles and life itself becomes harder, the very young are the first to suffer, not only by maddened and traumatized parents, but by social systems, governments, and educational institutions that regards them as expendable. For increasingly, they are seen as potential soldiers to police the colonial hinterlands, peons to do drudge work and dead-end jobs, or prisoners to people the prison industrial complex. From Death Row, this is Mumia Abu-Jamal.
These commentaries are recorded by Noel Hanrahan of Prison Radio.